Hey, Jay, how are you?
I'm all right.
Well, so much for that do not disturb sign. Huh?
I never read signs.
Yeah.
Thanks for having us. This is amazing.
Well, thanks for coming. Sure.
This is so cool. So how did you get into it? I mean, this is just a phenomenal collection.
Oh, I enjoy it. It's fun. It's fun to do. This is the first car I got when I came to California. I bought this car out of the Penny Saver for $350, and I lived in the car. I dated my wife in the car. Let's take a look at this. Before satellite radio, before CD players, before 8-tracks, you had the Highway Hi-Fi.
For real?
Oh, yeah, that's real. Yeah. It's a real option, yeah.
Presumably, bumps in the road are just going to send them.
Well, the idea is you're supposed to stop by the side of the road and you kind of play your records. You know?
Right.
The only records available were Davy Crockett and Pajama Game. That was pretty much Davy Crockett. That's the only record I could get. So, not quite as cool.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. And these old cars are sort of fun in that how cars have become, in some ways, much more sensible. For example, Don, let's say you work in a gas station, this car is pulled in, find the gas cap. All right, he's not gonna get it. Good day, Mr. Bond. I mean, it's just so, and look at the trunk in this.
It's fantastic.
You could rent this out to a family of four.
Do you have a favorite, Jay?
Well, I like them all. Whatever I'm driving, taking a moment is a favorite. This is an interesting car. This, you know, Gordon Murray, who designed the F1, of course, the famous F1 genius. This is one of his very first cars. It's called a Rocket. It only weighs 775 pounds. It's got 147 horsepower. You've got 12 speeds. 6 high, 6 low, and it's completely road legal. You see these headlights pop up here.
Yeah. So Americans love their sports. They love motorsports too. NASCAR, IndyCar.
Yeah, sure.
Not so much F1. Do you know why that is? Why it hasn't
taken off? Think F1 is overly technical. You know, I think Americans, and certainly I think in Europe too, people like to see race what they can buy, or what they, you know, in the 60s, NASCAR used to be high performance versions of the car you could actually buy. So if your dad was a Ford guy and Ford won that week, well, you go to school and we picked the Ford, but, you know, it was just the way it was. Now it's a little different. It's so complicated now that it's almost beyond, it's almost spacecraft, NASA-like now. I mean, it's so technical. The average guy in his garage really can't do much to his car to emulate it like an F1 car.
Is there anything you think would change that would make F1 more popular here?
Well, I think you need to make the engines a bit simpler, make them a little bigger, make them a little noisier. I mean, you know, people love the wail of the F1 engine, and that's what people like to watch. I remember the turbocharged era. Well, it was very exciting, you know, flames coming out the back, and the cars were fascinating to watch. You know, now, not so much.
You've been on a track with an F1 car.
Many times. It's pretty amazing. It's beyond the average person's threshold. I mean, race car drivers, people don't think of them as athletes the way they do perhaps a soccer player or something like that. The hand-eye coordination of a guy like Lewis Hamilton, I mean, it's unbelievable. It's so far beyond. It would be hard for the average person to enjoy an F1 car because things would be over. You'd hit the tree before you even realized anything had happened.
These cars are just beautiful sitting here, Jay, but we've got to drive them, right?
Sure,
can we take
some
for a spin?
Yeah, let's take the Stutz Bearcat. This is 1920.
Nice.
This car is, was it 96 years old?
Yeah.
No brakes? What could go wrong? Pump up the fuel, get fuel pressure.
May I, Jay?
Yeah, go right ahead.
All right.
There you are.
Thanks so much, Jay. We really
appreciate
your time.
Appreciate it. Thank you.